pressure for an ocean trickles the walloping window blind. No gale that blew dismayed a crew or troubled the captain's mind. The man at the wheel was taught to feel contempt for the wildest blow, but it oft appeared when the weather had cleared that he'd been in his bunk below. Fond of amusement too, he played up scotch at the starboard watch of the captain tickle the crew. And the gunner we had was apparently mad, he stood on the cannon's tail, fired salutes in the captain's boots at the teeth of the booming gale. The captain sat in a commodore's hat and dined in royal way on toasted pigs and pickles and figs and gummery bread each day. The rest of us ate from an odious plate of food that was given the crew. Number of tons of pork cross buns chopped up with sugar and glue. And we all fell ill as mariners will on a diet that's cheap and rude. The deck shook when we dipped the cook in a tub of his gruesome food. Vessel ashore on the gullaby isles with the poopoo smiles and the angans and his roar. We sat on the edge of the sandy ledge, we shot at the whistling bee. Binnacle bass wore waterproof fences, they danced in the sounding sea. On the rock of a bar from dawn to dark, we fed till we had grown. Uncommonly shrunk when a Chinese junk came up from the Torby zone. She was stubby and spare, we didn't much care, we didn't leave her to see. And left that crew on the junk to chew on the bark of the rug of our tree.